Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with the .NET MAUI DateTime Slider control. Using the .NET MAUI DateTime Slider, you can select a datetime value within a range by sliding a thumb along a track. Now, I will show you how easy it is to add the DateTime Slider control to the .NET MAUI application. I will also demonstrate how to bind value, set minimum and maximum values with intervals, labels, tooltips, ticks, dividers, and change the orientation. Before you begin, make sure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. Once you have installed the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the .NET MAUI application and give a project name and location. Here, I'll proceed to create the project with the .NET 7.0 framework. Now the project is ready. Before I move forward, let's take a quick detour to set up the environment for running our application. Here, I choose an Android emulator. For this demonstration, I will select the Pixel 5 Android emulator. Once the emulator is selected, I'll run the application and show you the default output. The application has started compiling the default code, so let's wait for a few seconds. And now the application's homepage is displayed. Next, I will demonstrate how to incorporate a Syncfusion.NET MAUI DateTime Slider into this application. I open the NuGet package manager. Search for the Syncfusion MAUI Sliders package and install it in my application. It will take a few seconds to complete the installation, so let's wait. Once the package is installed, I navigate to the main XAML page and remove the default scroll view related code. Then import the Syncfusion MAUI Sliders namespace. Now, initialize the control by adding the SFDateTime slider tag. Next, I need to register the Syncfusion core handler to map the cross-platform API to the native view API. So, open the MAUI program file and add Syncfusion MAUI core hosting. Then register the handler by adding the configure Syncfusion core method . To use the Syncfusion MAUI controls, it's necessary to register a trial license key. So, I open the app XAML CS file, add the register license method, and enter the trial license key. To find out where to generate the trial license key, refer to the description below. Then press the F5 key to run this application. See, the default DateTime slider is rendered, and you can drag the thumb to any point. Alright, let's see how to enable the labels on the DateTime slider. To do that, I enable the Show Labels property. Look here, slider renders with labels. However, you may notice that the labels in the tracks are congested. Suppose you want to customize the track range and intervals in the slider, you can use properties such as minimum, maximum, and value, among others. For example, if you want to represent the current financial year of the slider from April 2022 to March 2023, with an interval of 2, just set the minimum value to April 1, 2022. And the maximum value to March 31, 2023. The current value of the slider can be represented by the value property, which can be set to any date time within the range of the slider. I'll set the value to December 1, 2022. Since I'm going to show the slider values in months, set the interval type to month. And the interval is calculated based on the screen size, minimum and maximum value. So, I set the interval to 2. Check now, the track in the DateTime slider is customized based on provided values. In case you want to apply formats for labels, you can use the date format property. You can apply any available date and time format to this property, and now I set its value to custom month year format. And here, the month year format is applied to the labels. Next, I will show you how to enable the tick lines for the slider. To do that, I enable the showTicks property in the slider. You can also add the minor ticks between major ticks. To do that, I add the minor ticks per interval property and set its value to 1. Check now, major tick line is shown in the slider track. Here, the minor ticks are shown in between the major ticks. By default, the DateTime slider's highest value is shown on the right and the lowest value on the left. Suppose you want to inverse the slider, then enable the isInversed property. The slider renders with the highest value on the left side and lower values on the right side. Apart from these options, you also have another option to indicate the current selection of the year during interaction using a tooltip. To do that, I add the tooltip property. And include the slider tooltip. Check now, a tooltip is shown for the currently selected year. Next, I will show you how to divide the DateTime slider using shapes to represent the major interval points. To do that, I enable the showDividers property. Look now, the divider is shown for major interval points, but it looks too small. So, let me show you how to customize the active and inactive radius of the divider. To do that, I add a divider style property. Then, define the slider divider style with the active radius property to 4 and inactive radius to 7. See, the radius of the divider is increased based on the provided values. Next, I will show you how to select track values discretely. To do that, I include the step duration property and set its value to 0,2. Here, 0 represents year count and 2 represents the month count. And now, the values are selected discretely based on 2 months. Notice here, DateTime slider is rendered with a horizontal orientation by default. I can also show the slider in vertical orientation. To do that, I include the orientation property and set its value to vertical. See, the slider rendered with vertical orientation. Now let me quickly summarize what we have seen so far. I have shown you how to create a .NET MAUI application and add Syncfusion MAUI DateTime Slider Control with a few of its basic features. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, giving you a free license key to use our .NET MAUI products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.